Accidental Courtesy. Let's first of all talk about that title. Daryl, what does it mean?
Well, actually, it's a reverse of play on words. A courtesy accidental is a musical term, and I'm a musician. Right. You know, you have a scale, you have sharps and flats. Mm-hmm. Those are called accidentals. And you put one in the next measure as a courtesy to let somebody know that it's changing. So the producer and director just flipped the words around to accidental courtesy.
Mm. What made you begin this journey? Because you didn't, when you first started sitting down with KKK members and other races, you didn't intend to do a documentary, right?
No, not at all.
You just wanted to know why they hated you?
A personal journey to find out how somebody could hate me when they didn't even know me. Mm. And then I could share that with other people and perhaps address that problem.
Yeah.
But no, I never expected it to go this far. But I'm glad that it did, because people are being inspired. People are learning how to communicate with one another. We all live here together.
Yeah.
Right. So it's time we have to talk with one another.
Sure.
That's right.
Scott, what about you? Let's talk about this journey, how it has involved you, what you've learned about yourself, what you've learned about others.
Well, I've learned a lot about myself, really. Just, you know, of course, Daryl popped into my life at a very dark time. I didn't know where I was, didn't know who I was, or what I was going to do.
Were you still a racist at that time?
No. I had started transitioning out of that life, but I was in a period where I didn't have any friends. I didn't know who my friends were on this side. I definitely didn't have any here. Daryl caught me and popped into a very dark area. In that area, you know, I even contemplated suicide.
Wow. So if Daryl had asked you, why do you hate me, without even knowing me, what would you have said back in the day when you were a leader in the KKK?
To be honest, I wouldn't have had an answer. I would not have had an answer.
Would that have told you something about, why do I hate him?
Well, yes, it would have, because, you know, basically I always had this little voice in the back of my head that said, you know, do you really believe the things that you're saying and preaching? Because, as y'all know, I was raised by African-American lady Rebecca Scott Hawkins, who just passed away at 2 days before her 104th birthday in October.
Yep.
Wow.
And she was always in my life, and I knew I disappointed her, and she played a big part in it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, Daryl, these days, as you confront others, as you come in contact with so many people from so many different walks of life, many of whom look nothing like you or look nothing like me, what are you seeing these days? What are you feeling out there?
Well, you know, I look for the humanity in everybody. And even in my worst enemies, you can find some. I mean, I'm not so naive as to think that everybody will change.
Right.
You know, there will be those who will go to their grave being hateful, violent, and racist.
Right.
But if somebody is willing to sit down and talk with you, even if they have their totally opposite extreme views, that's a step. And if you spend 5 minutes with your worst enemy, you will find something in common. If you spend 10 minutes, you'll find even more. If you nurture those commonalities, you are forging a relationship. If you continue to nurture that relationship, you are forging a friendship, okay? And as you forge that friendship, the trivial things that you have in contrast, such as skin color, mm-hmm. or whether somebody goes to a temple, a mosque, a church, or a synagogue, mm-hmm. begin to matter less and less. Mm-hmm. And Scott brings up a very important point. You know, he said he was at a very dark point in his life where he's all alone, he didn't have friends here or there. That is very important, because, you know, when these people go to that extreme of joining some of these groups, that becomes their family. That is their family.
Mm-hmm. Okay? So it's hard for them to turn
away?
Well,
what happens is, you know, if they come from a non-racist family, let's say the family was not into that thing themselves, then the family more or less disowns them. Mm-hmm. Their friends disown them.
Gotcha.
Okay, now they have betrayed their pseudo family.
Right.
So you can never go back.
Right.
All right. So you're left out there hanging by yourself. And, you know, to have that stigma, it's not like, you know, oh, that guy got a speeding ticket, so let's not associate with him.
Yeah.
No, that guy was an ex-Klansman.
Right.
You know, it's a stigma.
So you're
Scott,
ready
what
to
you,
be that friend.
But what
exactly.
do you see, though, Scott, out there these days? Is a lot of people would argue that it feels as if, obviously, this country especially is more divided than ever, that perhaps more hate is out there than ever. What do you see? What are you sensing? What are you hearing from people who still may hold on to some of the thoughts or beliefs that you had years ago?
Well, I do see a lot of that going on, but I do think there is a common denominator. And the reason I joined and went in that direction, I came from a broken home, alcoholic father mm-hmm. that was very violent. And that is a common denominator. And, you know, and I feel like if we can, attack some of those things, we can mm-hmm. help a lot of these people.
So in a way, it's like any other gang.
Oh, right. Exactly. That's exactly what it is. I mean, and I've talked to some gang members.
Yeah.
And they definitely they had the same background.
So, Daryl, the last word is yours. What do you want the takeaway to be from someone who has a chance to see this new documentary?
Okay. Well, we all have heard the expressions, a tiger doesn't change his stripes, the leopard doesn't change his spots.
Mm-hmm.
I'm here to prove, and Scott's right here to prove it as well, that can't happen. You know, we have to have hope. If we have hope, you know, those changes can occur.
Well, we have to start the conversation. Thank
Absolutely.
You for starting the conversation.
Thank you.
And tonight exactly. is a great time to start it at the Civil Rights Museum. Come out and see
Absolutely.
The film.
A conversation that's needed more so than ever.
Never give up.
All right.